WDSU First Warning Weather. You see the impact day. This is for two things. It's going to be for the heat, also for poor air quality. You can see behind me that we've got some haze in the atmosphere. Gulfport, Island View, Casino, Cam. We've had storms there, but we're going to start with the tropics. We're tracking Ernesto. The thing is, no impacts to Louisiana. And I'm going to show you what's set besides Tropical Storm Ernesto that's there. It is actually charging right on through. This is the U.S. Virgin Islands, British Virgin Islands are just east, and there's Puerto Rico, U.S. territory. But look how large Ernesto is. This is a very large storm. In the expanse of the tropical storm force, winds out 115 miles on either side of the center. Look at the blossoming that's just starting to develop, showing some strengthening organization. But again, a very large storm. The latest, it's still moving pretty quickly, west-northwest at 18. It's going to strengthen to a Cat 1 hurricane as we go towards overnight tonight and towards tomorrow. Head to a Category 2 hurricane by the time we're getting to Thursday afternoon. Fortunately, Bermuda looks to be, they could be right in line for a Category 2, pretty strong on the high end of that Category 2 hurricane. And there are some indications that rapid intensification may be taking place, and maybe some of the strength forecasts are a little underdone. There still could be a long ways to go. The forecast tracks are in pretty good agreement of the track that would take it towards the island nation. But there are still chances that it could avoid that very small island compared to the size of that storm here that we just showed. Besides Ernesto, nothing in the greater Atlantic over the next 7 days. That is some very good news. Even better news, nothing in the Caribbean, nothing in the Gulf here. So we are all looking good for any storm that Ernesto's staying well away from, even the United States. If it would have any impact in North America, it could be coming in the form that hits Newfoundland in Canada.